Okay, I have now an eye contact to the screen. Apostolos, thank you very much for the invitation. It's a long time that we not have a meeting together. Now you are again in Lesbos with your Norwegian cultural armada, the people that we met first in the Moni Limonos, as you had organized the summer schools of the Norwegian University, and now we are again here. Now I'm an old professor, and you are a mature professor already, and it's very nice to meet and to spend some thoughts on some critical issue as the refugee crisis. Sometimes some critical situation is the opportunity to meet with the people that have the same path, are on the same path for a long time, for many years. And I'm already from the 70s on this path to work for political innovation, social integration. And in a meeting in Sarajevo, I had the opportunity to say to my German colleagues that I was also a political refugee in the time of Hunda. I'm not so old. At the time, I was a very young person. I have escaped from Greece as political refugee at 17 years of age, and I met a very, very pleasant environment in Germany, which has received me as political refugee, not only me, but also the other people from Greece that had the problem of Hunda. What is this, these memories are so pleasant? The positive factor that as a political and social refugee in Germany, at this positive experience is that at this time, this was a great change, a huge change for me, but also for the German youth. Both were on transition. The whole idea is to change society, and refugees, political refugees, the revolting youth in Germany, we had to collaborate. This common task, this common end, as Kant reflects the idea of a moral decision, this common end was the main tool for our collaboration and also for the integration of refugees, but not only the refugees, but for all people at that time, they were living in a social limbo, in a social vacuum. And now, after a long time, we have here a population of refugees. This is the second historical period of refugee crisis in Greece. The first was in 1922. Greece has received 1.5 million people and has integrated all these people very, very successfully in the society. And these people were considered not as Greeks at that time, but as refugees from, as aliens from other countries. But the society has the opportunity to integrate them because they gave the opportunity to establish ties between the refugee population and the local population, the host population, to establish ties, to organize common economic activities, to organize or to have a social relation and marriages between refugees population and the host population in the villages and in the cities. And after a long time, this refugee influx became the most innovative factor of the Greek society. The experience in Greece is 1922. The all innovation, economic, social, and political innovation came from this refugee influx. We have to consider this historical experience, because now we're speaking about refugee crisis as an invasion of aliens, that we have to manage these people as aliens, that they have to remain as aliens in our society, and they are most of them are in a social limbo, in a social vacuum, that this is because of the lack of social innovation in our society. Our society, not only the Greek society, all European society have a big problem, have a problem with social innovation. They have established an economy, a social institution, families, and families networks. And if a new population is coming to this already established organization, this is not easy to integrate these people if you don't reorganize the system and the networks of the society. And I want to start my presentation with this idea, to saying that the refugee concept is merely a narrow social and political concept, because it is collapsed to the idea of the human rights. If you understand the refugee crisis and you speak with anybody, political people, activists, religious leaders, all these people, they are speaking about the refugee crisis as a human rights crisis. We have to protect these people because of the human rights and the tradition of human rights in European society, in European culture. Modern state, the modern state and the supranational institution as European Union are collaborative in exercising a comprehensive control on the refugee population, the local host communities and the NGOs, and using for these financial instruments, surveillance and documentation network technology. This is the idea. We have to control them. State, modern state and supranational institutions are keen to work on this topic. And they are using everybody that they can for this idea. NGOs, individuals, professors, anybody. And we are thinking that we are protecting the human rights of these people if we collaborate on this system. This is not right. Because if we are going this way, there is a one-dimensional idea of the refugee populations. The one-dimensional population idea is that we have a population who is lacking of human rights, we have to protect and to give them rights. But what kind of rights? To give them food, and to give them shelters. This is the most important rights, important services that we can give to these people. We cannot give to them political rights, we cannot give them social rights to participate, and of course not cultural rights to participate in our society. There is a limit, a total limit between a boundary, because between the cultural life and cultural activities and dynamics of the local societies and this of the refugees. And if we are speaking about the refugees on this issue, there is an alien culture, mostly a hostile alien culture. There is no a culture that can receive as a positive influx in our society. This is the first idea. Of course, these people, in the same time, they tend to be victimized through ethnic and symbolic conflicts of their past, because they are here and they are bringing also their culture. If they have not, the possibility to be introduced to a modern, a new culture, to the whole society, the revival of their symbolic conflicts, the religious conflicts, it's normal. It's not something difficult. In Moria, the Iraqi are competing with the Afghanis. Afghanis are in their own ethnic society, although they have very high and difficult internal conflicts, and they have also problems with the people from Africa and other countries. All symbolic prejudices that are existing in their past, they are very, very badly revived in these camps. Because the camp life, it is, of course, the best platform to have social and cultural conflicts. Can you remember that the camp life and camp organization, it is a reactionary innovation of Europe? This is not something new. You know that is introduced to European culture through the Nazi regime. Camps, it's not something new. Camps is to bring people somewhere, to control them totally, and to give them something that let them for a while, for a time alive, and sometimes also to extinguish them. Okay, this is not the case in Moria, this is not the case in other camps, but if you are bringing people in camps, the idea is to control totally human life. 3 minutes, okay. To control totally human life. I have 3 minutes and I want to have some more things to say. I will use this 3 minutes productive. And I want to say that this idea, it is to understand refugees in a more extended concept that is using all these factors that are forming the refugee identities. There are here in my presentation, there are five factors that are defining the refugee identity. One of them is that I have also presented the bureaucratic identity. Another is the political and social arena in the host country. Another is the performance of the demographic profile of these people, and also the political identity of the national and supranational institutions. They are forming what is a refugee, what is not a refugee, how we have to treat them. And the second is the debate about the refugee flows, defining the refugee identity, and this is different in all European countries. Is another in Germany, another in Greece, another in Italy. The problem is now to think about how we can introduce social innovation. Social innovation for me, I have not enough time to explain this, it is to fill this social vacuum. This vacuum can be filled with many different innovative ideas. One of them is practices, social practices on the grassroots level. Another is innovative practices on the personal level, how we react as persons, as citizens, how we understand these people as a form of citizens. We can react and discuss with them. We have to introduce them to our society as people. The most positive idea I had with migrants and refugees is that if we invite them to your home and to speak with them, this is a very, very positive action. Something much better if you to give money and something other to them. And of course, I want to say we have organized a research in Idomeni, but also a research in many European countries to register and to document innovative ideas and practices and best practices for integrating refugees and migrants, and innovative ideas to fill on to fill the gap of this social vacuum between the host population and the refugees. And I think this is Apostolos has mentioned this already, is that this is a very, very important issue for our societies also, because Greece, and not only Greece, other societies are coping with the problem of social innovation. This is a huge problem also in our societies. And we are struggling to reform our societies and to cope with the problem of crisis. And the refugee crisis can be an opportunity and not a political or a social weapon between groups and political parties and everything, also between societies and states. This is my idea. Of course, in our research, we have documented many different positive innovative practices, and also you are invited, or we are ready to cooperate with anybody who wants to work on this issue. I want to finish with this as responsible for the School of Social Sciences of Mytilene. I've invited all the presidents of the departments of the school, and I have asked them to organize a synergetic approach on the refugee issue, to put all the researchers together, to put all the results of our research, and to organize something innovative in a synergetic form, not to have 10, 15 different research approaches without any communication between them. And innovation is also to communicate it, between the different actors, and also to use also technology as a social actor, not as a technological fact. Thank you.